think transgender issues have gotten a little bit ahead of themselves. And I think it's very important now that the adults in a room, that it's American medicine, comes in and starts to kind of fine-tune some things. The places where I see some issues are with patients less than 18 and patients older than 55. For a medical student, the key thing here first is that they have to understand that there's no room for bigotry and bias. It's really important that young medical students, as well as young dental students, understand how to create a welcoming environment for this group of patients. Don't assume anything. Just ask a question. How would you like me to address you? Therapy is absolutely critical. Therapy should not end after you transition. That's only the beginning. We need to have a continuity of care. We need to have follow-up with these patients. What I'm seeing with a lot of the osteopathic docs, they are approaching it from a circumferential approach. For someone who's going to be transitioning over 55 years old, the first thing I would have them focus on is how to maintain and create good relationships and a support group. It's absolutely critical. And as a healthcare provider and as a future healthcare provider, that's most assuredly what it's about. It's about treating people as human beings.
We don't often include people who are members of the LGBT community or people with disabilities. You know, sometimes they're considered the invisible minorities, and so for me, it's making them visible. That's what cultural competency is about. It's training our students and our healthcare practitioners to ask the right questions, making sure that they're creating a space for them that feels as though it's welcoming and that it's inclusive.